الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Just before we start the seerah for tonight, just a reminder for myself and for my brothers of Allah. Always when you sit in a gathering in the masjid, put yourself in that atmosphere. Because that's the promise of the Prophet ﷺ. It's not my gift. It's not something that I'm giving anybody. It's that what the Prophet ﷺ said about any gathering in the masjid. It says Allah sallam, اجتمع قوم في بيت. Any people get together in a masjid about something like that. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reading Quran, talking about hadith, anything beneficial. Illa, they will get four things. غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمِ. They will be, inshallah ta'ala, showered by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمِ السَّكِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the tranquility to their hearts and upon them. وَحَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. That the angels will be surrounding them. And number four, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention them to His angels. وَذَكَّرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنَامِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention those people to His angels. Yani simply, anything, not only with me, yani anything happens in masjid, you have 10 minutes, 15 minutes, just sit. Sit to get that reward. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention you by name to the angels. Remember so-and-so, he left watching his game, and he stayed in the masjid. He told the wife, you know what, give me 15 minutes for myself. You know, everybody is busy with the kids. Speaking of the kids, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, if you didn't bring your kids yet, alhamdulillah, we have a very, very nice program for the kids from 6:30 to 8 p.m. every Friday, mashallah. Today I made sure that, mashallah, we have a good number of kids and everything was running very well, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. And that's why we're here, man. That's why we come to the masjid. For them, for our kids. Although they're giving us our time. What's your name?
Hashim.
Hassan? What?
Hashim.
Hashim. Talib Ali Hashim. Sit down, please. So although, but we need to get them in the masjid. We need to get them to feel that there is something called masjid for them. And they are welcome in the masjid. They might be giving us some, you know what, we have to discipline them at the end of the day. But you are before them, sitting in the masjid, they will follow you. If you are sitting home and watching TV, most of the time, they will be doing the same. Not even watching TV, I'm telling you. They will take their iPads and their whatever, and they will go to their room. They don't care about you. But you need to make some effort to be example for them. That's why we started the halaqa almost. 2 years ago, here in the masjid, we've been talking about the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ for 1 year and 10 months. Yani sometime we take some days off, but mainly since I came here, 1 year and 10 months. We've been talking about the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, the biography, the life of the Prophet ﷺ, but not done yet. That's an example that we should follow. Why we do this? I said before, Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, one of the great Sahaba, said that we used to teach the battles, the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ to our kids, as we used to teach them the surah from the Quran. We're so worried. I need him to read Quran. I need him to understand. I need him to memorize Quran. Great. Everybody think the same like you. Don't think that you're like old fashioned. Everybody, no matter how education he has as parent, they still want their kids to start with the Quran, which is something, subhanAllah, it's a unique nature of the Muslim Ummah. We need our kids to be connected to the Quran, but I need to lead them first. Believe me, wallah. If we're not gonna lead them, if we're not gonna show them the example that they should follow, we will lose them. That's why we have the seerah. We started the seerah and we share it with one another for this reason. You know, you bring a story, it's not about the story. You bring the story and you share it with them and you try to take the example from the story all the time. You know what? Look what the Prophet ﷺ did in this situation. You know what? That's the lesson that can be taken. Always try to do like that. And the kids, they love the stories. That's why for the event that I have for the kids, we put a program for playing, connecting them to the masjid, and a story, fun prophet. Each week, we have a story, fun prophet. Quickly, not to overburden them with the information, rather to get them connected to the masjid. طيب. Last week I started talking about the Treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah. I didn't mention, by the way, in which year the Treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah happened. I mentioned it, but I need somebody to remind me. When was it? Yeah, the sixth year. Which month? Dhul-Qa'dah. Yeah, that's exactly where the Prophet ﷺ saw that dream that he's making Umar. So, you know, it's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go make Umrah. Sahaba, how many of the Sahaba went to the Prophet ﷺ quickly? Or tried to go? Huh? How many? 1400, mashallah, Hasan. So 1400 of the Sahaba went to the Prophet ﷺ, people of Quraysh stopped them, you're not getting in. I can't go over all the details that I mentioned last week because I have a very yani, related events for today, so I cannot skip any of them. But we stopped at the point when the Prophet ﷺ sent Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan to the people of Quraysh. The Prophet ﷺ camped at that place, Al-Hudaybiyah. Sent Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan to tell the people of Quraysh that we're not here to fight, we're here to make Umrah. Can you allow us? They hold him for a bit. The Sahaba, they thought that they killed him. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the pledge of allegiance from all the Sahaba with him that we will be with you. We're not going to go and leave you alone. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised those Sahaba in Surah Al-Fatih. لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايِعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with those who gave you pledge of allegiance under that tree, which is called the Bay'at Al-Aqaba. Not Al-Aqaba, sorry, Ar-Rudwan. Jazakallah khair. Bay'at Ar-Rudwan. طيب, anyway, I said at that point, يعني, people of Quraysh or the Quraysh people, they are not ready to fight. The Prophet ﷺ is not here to fight. However, they brought their arms with them, their armors, their weapons and everything. But at the end of the day, the Prophet ﷺ is coming in the sixth year after Hijrah. Imagine. Some people might think, you know what? يعني, it's hard for me to go for Hajj and for Umrah. And you know what? I hope to go. It's a great feeling. But don't think that the Prophet ﷺ was making Umrah every day. Yeah? And people, I know people, wallah al-azim, yani, it's not about how many Umrah and Hajj you make. We know friends, they live over there and they don't have that feeling that you have. They don't even go. They just go like that, yani, for fun. Yani. They don't, yani, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made him win Umrah. تحكوا ليه؟ عشان عارفين اني صح, صح؟ So, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made 3 Umrah and that was not even the first one yet. In the sixth year after Hijrah, he didn't go for Umrah and he made one Hajj. The farewell Hajj, it was one time Hajj. Okay? So make dua, plan for it, and Allah will make it easy, inshallah ta'ala, for you. طيب, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is camping with the Sahaba at Al-Hudaybiyah, the people of Quraysh in Mecca, and here is يعني, the main negotiation about the treaty. What happened? First of all, Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan came back, came safe, so no fight, no nothing. فَجَاءَ a rajul, you know, we have four names, يعني, try to memorize them if you can. يعني, very, very easy names like Muhammad and Mahmoud, يعني, the way you will memorize them very easily. The first one of them, Budayl ibn Warqa. Right? Very easy name, right? Say it, Sulaiman. So, Budayl ibn Warqa al-Khuza'i. This is a nice, يعني, and we're talking about, يعني, if you have your friend, let's put it this way, example. Your friend, you have a close friend of yours. He is in a little problem with another friend in the masjid. Two brothers, they're having a little bit trouble in their relationship. And you know about it. Don't wait. Yani until they fight and try to go to this one by himself. You know what? I heard him talking about you. And to go to this one, you know what? You're right. Let's not talk to him anymore. No, ya akhi. Just go and try to make it easy between them. Those people, however, they were not Muslims, but they were Arab. They have this يعني, manhood. They have this honor in their personalities, and they don't like it to happen this way between them, between Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the people of Quraysh. One of them, the first one to jump to the scene and to offer his help through negotiation was Budayl ibn Warqa al-Khuza'i. He went to the people of Quraysh. Actually, he went to the Prophet ﷺ first. And you guys know that the Prophet ﷺ said it clearly. I'm not here to fight. And if they give me any offer, I will take it. Any offer through which I will, we both will respect the sanctity of Al-Masjid al-Haram, I will accept. I have no problem. So Budayl ibn Warqa went to the Prophet ﷺ and told him clearly, Ya Muhammad, إِنَّ قُرَيْشًا خَرَجَتْ بِكُلِّ مَا تَمْلِكُ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَنَزَلَتْ بِالْحُدَيْبِيَةِ عِنْدَ الْمَاءِ وَهُمْ مُقَاتِلُوكَ وَصَدُّوكَ عَنِ الْبَيْتِ. First of all, he tried to scare the Prophet ﷺ off. Yani he wants to solve it, but anyway, even the Prophet ﷺ will leave. Yani they don't care. He said that Quraysh is talking to the Prophet ﷺ that Quraysh is out with all of its people. And they're at Al-Hudaybiyah on the other side, around the water. So they're stronger than you. And they will stop you from entering Al-Bayt Al-Haram, no matter how it takes. They don't care. They will stop you. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّا لَمْ نَجِئْ لِقِتَالِ أَحَدٍ ولكننا جئنا معتمرين وان قريشا قد انهكتهم الحرب واضرت بهم فان شاءوا مادتهم مده اي جعلت بيني وبينهم مده. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, you know what, we're not here to fight, we're just here to make umrah. And I know for sure that they're tired. It's been Badr in the second year after Hijrah, Uhud in the third year after Hijrah, Al Ahzab in the fifth year after Hijrah. In less than 2, 3, 4, 5. In 4 years, they had 3 big wars. So they're tired. I know that they're tired. And I'm not here to fight. Let's go and offer them that we have a period of time that ceasefire, you know, yani like something like ceasefire, like no war for this time. Look how the Prophet ﷺ is looking at the people of Quraysh. I was talking about this today. How to have a sound heart. Yani, although they aren't fighting, the Prophet ﷺ is thinking positively about them. In this time, if I'm going to be yani, a prophet and everybody follows me, at least yani, I don't have to fight with them. And if I don't yani, become yani, popular and people follow me, they get rid of me. They're done. They don't have to fight. وَيُخَلُّ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ النَّاسِ فَإِنْ أَظْهَرْ فَإِنْ شَاءُوا أَنْ يَدْخُلُوا فِي مَا دَخَلَ فِيهِ النَّاسِ فَعَلُوا وَإِلَّا فَقَدْ رُحِمُوا وَإِنْ أَظْهَرْ أَنَا عَلَى غَيْرِهِمْ فَإِنْ شَاءُوا وَطَعُونِي وَإِلَّا فَلَا تَنْقُصْ أَوْ تُنْقَضِي مُدَّةُ الصُّلْحِ إِلَّا وَقَدْ اسْتَرَاحُوا وَقَوْا. حتى even the Prophet ﷺ is thinking about them to be stronger at the end of this time. طيب بُدَيْلَ بْنُ وَرْقَةَ, the first negotiator, take this information. Remember, I said the name almost 5 times now. What's the name, Stas?
I don't remember.
Al-Khuza'i. Al-Khuza'i. Good job, mashallah.
That's the most important.
Okay, طيب. يعني بُدَيْلِ بْنُ وَرْقَى still the easiest of the names that I have for today. فَيَكَدْ إِمَاتِنْ يَعْنِ. يعني سهيل بن عمرو is the easiest, to be honest with you, the last one. But there are two more that you will find hardship saying it. So keep saying بُدَيْلِ بْنُ وَرْقَى, بُدَيْلِ بْنُ وَرْقَى, بُدَيْلِ بْنُ وَرْقَى, until we finish. طيب. And if they don't, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at the end, يعني I'm here to make umrah, I don't want to fight. But if they want to fight, I'm here. I can do it. يعني at the end of the day, I can protect myself and I can protect my followers. That's the saying of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فبُدَيْلِ بْنُ وَرْقَى went back to the people of Quraysh and he told them, يَا شَبَابْ, I come to you with an offer from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَقَالَ سُفَهَاءُهُمْ, always you will find those people. In any negotiation, you will find somebody comes to you, no, we don't care. We don't want to listen. Some of them, they said that, we don't want to listen. We don't want to say anything. We don't want him to enter. He's not allowed to enter Mecca. Let him go. ولكن قال دعوا الرأي منهم. Then the people of those who thought and they have wisdom, they said, no, let's listen. We'll see how it works. They know that they're weak. But maybe those who started saying no, they're like the youth and the يعني they don't have this wisdom. فقالوا هاتي ما سمعت. Give us what you have. Then he offered them, he told them about what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. فقال لهم, the second name, then there was a man again with them, another well-known person at that time. Uwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi. So the first one is Udayl ibn Min? Ibn Waqar al-Khuza'i. The second one. Suhail is still. Suhail is coming at the end.
Second one is
Thaqafi. Thaqafi, mashallah. Urwata ibn Mas'ud al-Araqi. Al-Thaqafi. This man was very well-known person in the Arabic or the Arabic peninsula at that time. Everybody knows Urwata ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi except us. Anyway. فقال إن هذا الرجل he told them, people, think about the offer that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم sent to you. This is a very nice offer. فقالوا يعني فقبلوا ودعوني آتي. يعني he advised them to accept the offer of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he offered to go himself to continue the negotiation with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ودعوني آتي. قالوا آتي. Just go and meet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. What happened between the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Urwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi in the dialogue that happens and the reaction of the Sahaba tells you exactly that those people, I was talking about them today. الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يُحِبُّونَ وَالَّذِينَ هَبَوُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ. Those people, the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ, again, ya shabab, they used to love the Prophet ﷺ more than themselves. ولذلك, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ذلك. يعني أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. يعني if you really have iman in your heart, if you want to have a perfect iman and a complete faith in Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم more than you love your own self. And that happened here. Urwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and look what he said. First thing. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم over the same, فقال له عروة يا محمد جئت لقتال قومك فإن قتلتهم فهل رأيت أحدا قبلك اجتاح قومه وإن كانت الأخرى فإني والله أرى حواليك أوباشا خليقا أن يفروا عنك ويدعوك. لطش شوي. He started irritating the Sahaba around the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. First of all he said, يا محمد, you came here, you're here to fight your people, and if you do so, have you heard before that any But he did the same and he killed his people. And if they fight you, I'm sure that those awbash, awbash, يعني, sorry that he's trying to say it about the Sahaba, يعني, and I don't want to repeat it. يعني, it's not a nice word about the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. And he's saying that they will leave you alone, that then they will run away. يعني, he's talking to the Prophet ﷺ, be careful, man. Like as if he is advising him, be careful, man. يعني you're coming to fight. If the people of Quraysh went out and they fight you, those people around you, they will let you alone, they will run away. The Prophet ﷺ didn't talk. Look what Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said. قال له سيدنا أبو بكر رضي الله عنه أمصص بضر اللات أنحن نفر عنه وندعه. يعني هو قال له, he told him an expression of that time, I don't want to say it but in English, but he told him an expression that يعني take hike, man. What are you talking about? والله يعني you don't يعني هو قال له كلمة يعني very very tough. He told him a very very tough words in the Abu Bakr as-Siddiq to whom? I forgot the name. عروة
بن
مسعود ثقفي, who was the second one in negotiation. The first one was Uday ibn Waqa الخزاعي. ما شاء الله, خلاص والله ما شاء, you passed. ف he told him, you know, also, يعني he told him a very tough word and he told him, you know what, we'll never let him alone, we will never do that. Then Urwa, he didn't recognize Sayyidina Abu Bakr. He said that, who's this? Who's talking here? فقالوا هو أبو بكر الصديق. This is Abu Bakr. فقال له يا أبا بكر والله لولا يد لك عندي لم أجزك أو أجزك بها أجزك بها سوري أجزك بها لأجبته. يعني هي انسلطت سيدنا أبو بكر انسلطت عروة بن مسعود الثقفي. However, Umar told him, answered or replied to him saying that, you know what, if you're not, it was not you, I would have responded, but you have, you did a favor to me before and I have to respect that. Yeah, imagine, they're fighting, they're different religion, but they still respect one another. Remember what I said today about Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib and Sayyidina Talha ibn Ubaidillah? Yani, they're fighting, but he's in trouble, I'll help him. طيب. Then Urwa was like trying again to irritate the Prophet himself. He is trying to get closer to the beard of the Prophet. Touched the beard of the Prophet. It's one of the great Sahaba, his name Sayyidina al-Mughira ibn Shu'ba radiallahu anhu, is close to the Prophet. And whenever Urwa tried to touch the beard of the Prophet, he pushed him with the back of his sword. Like that. Like, stay away, man. Don't touch the Prophet ﷺ, exactly like that. Stay away, don't touch the Prophet ﷺ. For again he asked him, who's this person? Who are you? Again, he doesn't know Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah. For Sayyidina Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah, in the Jahiliyyah, he had a crime in Jahiliyyah. He had a big sin in Jahiliyyah. If you were not Muslim, خلاص, and you accepted Islam, anything happened in Jahiliyyah, absolutely done. However, if this sin in Jahiliyyah involves the rights of the people, you have to return the right back to its owner. Very important. Yani, I was in Jahiliyyah before my Islam. I'm giving example. Alhamdulillah, I was born Muslim. Before my Islam, I stole some money from a store. I went to 7-Eleven and I liked something, then I put it in my pocket and I left. Yani, whatever it is, $5, $10, $20, $100, whatever it is. Then I accepted Islam, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive everything for me. If I drink, if I did zina, if anything I did before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive it. Everything. Except for this money, property of somebody. Yani, it's not me. Sayyidina al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah had something like that before his Islam. He killed some people and he took their money. Urwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi wanted to irritate Sayyidina Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah when he pushed him with his sword, with the back of his sword, he wanted to remind him with what he did in Jahiliyyah. Yani, now you're coming to me, remember when you're behaving like a sheikh. Remember when you were not praying? I saw you many times in White Lab, man. You were drinking, you were like, that's the behavior of the people. But he was trying to do the same with Sayyidina Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah. فَيَقُولْ لَهُ أَوَلَسْتَ أولست أسعى في بدرتك؟ يعني you're talking about, you are Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah, you're talking to me. Remember when I was trying to solve your problem in Jahiliyyah, when you kill the people and you took your money? حتى إذن when Sayyidina Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and accepted Islam, and he told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about this, فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أما الإسلام فأقبل. As for Islam, you be Muslim. But أَمَّا الْمَالُ فَلَسْتُ مِنْهُ فِي شَيْءٍ. As for the property, as for the money, you have to return it back. It's not, I can't forgive you for that. You have to return it back. Anyway, Urwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi, when he saw all of this happening around the Prophet ﷺ, he realized that it's not about leading some people and then they're looking for position or they're, no. Those people, they sacrificed literally. They sacrificed their life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet. Clearly. فَرَجَعَ عُرْوَةَ إِلَىٰ قُرَيْشِ. And he saw Urwa, he told them, and when he went back to the people of Quraysh, told them, يَا أَخِي, I went to the man when he was trying to make wudu, his companions, they fought one another, who was gonna give him the water to make wudu? Yani, I never seen like that. فيقول عروة بن مسعود الثقفي, when he went back to the people of Quraysh, he told them, saying, لقد أتيت والله لقد وفدت على الملوك على قيصر وكسرى والنجاشي والله ما رأيت ملكا يعظمه أصحابه كما يعظم أصحاب محمد محمدا. So I've been to all the kings, Caesar, whatever the Najashi Negus, I've been to all kings. I never seen people glorifying and dignifying their king as the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do the same with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he advised the people of Quraysh to accept the يعني, or to go into a treaty with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but they refused. For the second one. Number three. فقام رجل من كنانة فقال دعوني آتيه. Those people, the people of Kunana, they were known in that time that they respect al-budna, anything was sacrificed. يعني they respect al-nusuk. They respect anything happens for the rituals of the Hajj. Somebody, نعم يا سلام. Good.
You mentioned that Quraysh would use. But we know that in negotiation, there's always a leader who leads the negotiation. Who's leading the negotiation for the Quraysh?
At that time, we can say that it was Sufyan ibn Harb, mainly because he was the leader of Quraysh. Okay. However, Abu Sufyan ibn Harb, he was the leader. Since the battle of Uhud, he's the main leader of Quraysh at that time. So he was the main one to talk, and it will be clear at the conquest of Mecca that he was the main person at that time.
He was.
Yeah. However, يعني, he was not the only one to talk. As I said earlier, some of them they said no, some they're not into negotiation because they understand, they have wisdom, and they understand that they are weak. طيب. Those people, the people of Kinana, they were known لاحترامهم للنسك. If somebody is coming to do Umrah, absolutely they respect that, or to do Hajj around even whatever the religion they follow. If he's coming to visit Al-Masjid Al-Haram, they will let them and they respect that. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم knew that this man from Kinana, his name is not mentioned in the seerah, and those people they are known for their respect for the nusuk, for the rituals of the Hajj and Al-Masjid Al-Haram. So let's meet him with sacrificing with our budn. Yani let's meet him with our cattle, the sheep and goats that we are bringing to slaughter for our umrah. Once they see that, they will not talk. And that's exactly what happened. وَاسْتَقْبَلَهُمْ قَوْمْ يُلَبُّونَ They received him, they welcomed him, saying, لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ فلما راى البدن وسمع التلبيه قال سبحان الله ما ينبغي لهؤلاء ان يصدوا عن البيت. Right away, he didn't even went into any negotiation. He saw them saying لبيك اللهم لبيك. They having their sacrifice with their hands. Those people they're coming for umrah, they're not coming for fight. They cannot be banned from entering المسجد الحرام. Went back to the people of Quraysh. Then they sent Mikriz ibn Hafs, which is very very easy yani name again. So we have the names again. The first one, Udayl ibn Warqa. Second one, Urwat ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi. Third one, somebody from Kinana, his name is not mentioned. And number four, Mikriz ibn Hafs. Mikriz ibn Hafs. This is the easiest of all of them. Okay? And then again the same, they didn't agree. And then the last one to be sent was Sayyidina Suhail ibn Amr radiallahu anhu. They sent Suhail ibn Amr. When the Prophet knew that Suhail ibn Amr is sent, he said it clearly. لَقَدْ سَهَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for you that Suhail ibn Amr is coming to lead the negotiation because Suhail is so wise man, he was known. And Sayyidina Suhail ibn Amr, amazing, he has an amazing stand right after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We'll talk about it inshallah ta'ala when we come to that. Sayyidina Suhail ibn Amr came. I'm saying Sayyidina Suhail ibn Amr, however, he was not Muslim at that time, but he was one of the great, great Suhail. Came, and I'm gonna, now we're into exactly, khalas, Suhail ibn Amr comes to write the agreement. He's not gonna do negotiation. Just write it and they agree on something. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is coming to do what? Umrah. Is it fair to tell him no, not this year, go back on the back of your mount and then come next year? It's not fair. Is it fair to tell the Prophet ﷺ that anybody accept Islam from our side and goes to you, send him back. And anybody comes from your side, leaving his Islam to us, we don't send him. Is it fair? It's not fair. Many things that happen in this treaty, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it happen this way. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, as I said last week, يقول إنكم تعدون الفتح فتح مكة وإنما الفتح صلح الحديبية. The main way, the main gate of the conquest of Mecca was this treaty, the treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah. However, we look at it, that was not fair at all, but the Prophet ﷺ agreed on most, on everything actually they asked for, because he said at the beginning, I will agree on anything through which we both respect the sanctity of Al-Masjid al-Haram. How it goes, Sayyidina Suhail ibn Amr came, وَقَالَ هَاتِي أُكْتُبْ. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم called the writer, اكتب, write down. First, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يعني أخي, أنت when you talk to somebody, not Muslim, and he doesn't understand what you're saying, explain it to him. حتى if he said, no, I don't care about this, you have to, not to respect it, but you have to understand that he doesn't follow that. يعني, أنا, I'm not gonna talk to, يعني, imagine that يعني, a Muslim is talking to a non-Muslim and keep like saying that, ya akhi, if you don't do that, if you do that, you will be in the hellfire. Ya akhi, hellfire, yeah, sure. He doesn't know anything. You have to speak his language. You have to appreciate that he doesn't know that. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. فيقول له سهير بن عمرو, أما الرحمن الرحيم فلا نعرف. As for this part, الرحمن الرحيم, we don't know that. Who's Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? We don't know that. Just write, Bismika Allahum. They use, as you used to write in the Jahiliyyah. He's saying to the Prophet ﷺ, write it, man, write it the way that we used to write it before. طيب, at the end of the day, we say Allah, we say God. Who's your God? يعني, if somebody is talking to you, who's your God? Who's your God? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني, somebody uses the word God, uses, يعني, what's in your heart is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقال سهيل أما الرحمن فوالله ما أدري ما هي. I don't know what is this. ولكن اكتب باسمك اللهم كما كنت تكتب. فقال المسلمون والله لا نكتبها إلا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The Muslims, they said that, you know what, some people then when you're in negotiation, in يعني, some people they come on يعني little things and make big deal out of it. أخي المسلمين, no, we need to write بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that, hold on, just write it as you want. باسمك اللهم هذا ما قاضى عليه محمد رسول الله. This is what Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, agrees on with. فسهيل بن عمرو يقول له والله لو نعلم أنك رسول الله ما صدناك عن البيت. يعني, if we know that you are the messenger of Allah, we will never ban you from the house. We don't like, some people, by the way, even Abu Sufyan, speaking of Abu Sufyan, ya Sulaiman, until the Prophet ﷺ entered Mecca and Abu Sufyan accept Islam or try to accept Islam, imagine what he said. Those people, they were honest, I'm telling you, they were honest, they will say it, they don't care. He went to the Prophet ﷺ. Before going to the Prophet ﷺ, he was talking to Al-Abbas, the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ. Ya Abu Sufyan, are you ready to announce Islam? فقال له, you know what? As for La ilaha illallah, one God, I'm okay. But as for Muhammad as the messenger of Allah, I still have doubts. The moment before he announces Islam, hatta they said that some of the Sahaba, they said that we know, Sayyidina Umar said it. We know that he said it to protect himself. But afterwards, he's one of the great Sahaba. For some people like that, يعني, some people they come to you, I believe in God. طبعاً, we get excited sometimes, by the way. Some people, like if a friend of your co-workers said, I believe in God, one God. MashaAllah, this brother is like almost Muslim. But I don't believe in Muhammad. Musibah, anyway. And somebody does not believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a messenger of Allah, he is not Muslim, but good job. I'll give you candy after the salah. I don't want to say it in the camera, but good, that's why. Very good job, that's why. Clearly, he disbelieves in Allah. If you don't believe in Muhammad, you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away, straightforward. However, I don't go to him and say that you're kafir. I don't care. It's not my job to go to the people and say that you're kafir. Come here. This group of people, kuffar. This group is fasiq. This one is fajr. This one is like between. And this one, those people, mashallah, they will be the people of Jannah. Who are you to judge the people? It's not your job. Let the people practice. Tell them this is the right way. And they practice, inshallah ta'ala. Anyway. Faqal. If we know that you are the messenger of Allah, we will never ban you from entering the Masjid al-Haram. فَكَتَبَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ اُكْتُبْ مُحَمَّدْ ابْنِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. Yes, we know you. You are Muhammad, the son of Abdullah. فَكَتَبَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي بَسْ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ didn't let it go. وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ أَنِّي رَسُولُ أَوْ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَإِنْ كَذَّبْتُمُونِي. يعني I know. When you guys know 100% that I'm the messenger of Allah, although you disbelieve in me, but I'm still the messenger of Allah. Uktub Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Write Muhammad ibn Abdullah. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ. We said that the Prophet ﷺ promised that anything they will offer, they will accept it. ثُمَّ قَالَ أُكْتُبْ عَلَىٰ أَن تُخَلُّوا بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْبَيْتِ فَنَطُوفِي. فَقَالَ سُهَيْبٌ وَاللَّهِ لَا تَتَحَدَّثَ الْعَرَبُ أَنَّا أُخِذْنَا ضَغْتًا وَلَكِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي الْعَامِ الْمُقْبِلِ. نعم.
Who's writing?
They didn't mention the writer.
I thought it was Ali.
I don't have it here. Sayyidina Ali, by the way, ya shabab. Ana, the ahadith that I'm getting is the authentic ahadith in this regard. But there are many ahadith. I'm not sure if it's mentioned, the writer, Sayyidina Ali, or not. But there is some ahadith saying that.
The story that I think most of us know is that Ali was writing, and the Prophet ﷺ agreed with Suhail to strike down Rasulullah and write Muhammad ibn Abdullah. And Ali refused. And the Prophet ﷺ took the pen or whatever they were using and did it himself, which creates a controversy about whether the Prophet ﷺ was indeed illiterate or not. Because
these are details. These are details, to be honest with you, that does not mention in the authentic hadith. Details. I don't know. Yani. I'm not saying it's wrong, but yani, I personally can't rely on it until I make sure that it's authentic. Jazakallah khair. But Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, anyway, yani, he's telling them, you know, he's asking Suhail ibn Amr, can you guys allow us to make tawaf this year? We're coming for Umrah. Well, what are the pillars of Umrah, by the way? The pillars of Umrah. Salah al-Sum. يا عم اللي انت بتقوله يا عبد الله خد يا محمد عاوز ينام شك so we have four things for umrah four pillars only ihram we having the ihram the prophet ﷺ had the ihram because they have to make ihram from dhul hulayfa abyar ali they already in state of ihram number two tawaf number three sa'i and number four oh mashallah you're fresh فرش معتمر يعني. He did it last day. Jazakallah khair. Anyway, فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is asking Suhail ibn Amr, just let us go, make tawaf. You're still a member, Saeed, right? Everything about Umrah, mashallah. No man. We had good time over there, alhamdulillah. Inshallah, we go there again, inshallah. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was making tawaf. He asking him to allow him to make tawaf. Suhail ibn Amr, all what they think about is power. They don't care about religion at all. And I said that before. He told them, you know what? Let's not talk about this here. We don't want to have the people, Arab people, say that you guys forced us. And you entered upon us by force. Will never happen. Go and come next year. فيعني فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني اكتب فكتب. Just write it, خلاص. I agree. You will see what Sayyidina Umar will do after. يعني, it's not only Sayyidina Ali, all the Sahaba after all, but Sayyidina Umar took a very, very harsh stand from that. He didn't like it at all. He didn't agree on it at all. But later on, he will understand that it was for the benefit of the Muslimin 100%. The next point, وَعَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ لَا يَأْتِيكَ رَجُلٌ وَإِنْ كَانَ عَلَىٰ دِينِكَ إِلَّا رَأَىٰ. Anybody comes to you, even he is Muslim, you return him to me, to us. Non-Muslim, you return him. And if anybody comes from your side to our side, we don't return them. They're just riding. وفي واحد اسمه أبو جندل ابن سهيل ابن عم. His son, the son of Suhail ibn Amr, entered at that moment. Sayyidina Abu Jandal was, when you read about his life, he was like slow decision maker. He was Muslim, but he was like trying to compromise his father, Islam, stay in Mecca, go to Medina. His brother Abdullah went from day one with the Prophet ﷺ. But Sayyidina Abu Jahl was slow. But when he saw that there is agreement and treaty, let's go. Yani, join the Prophet ﷺ before they signed the agreement. At that moment, they didn't sign yet. Sayyidina Abu Jandal came to join the Prophet ﷺ and the Muslimin. Jandal, who is the son of Suhail ibn Amr, the Nigerian. فدخل وكان قد أسلم فحبسوه وأوثقوه في الحديث فهرب منهم ومقيد حتى رمى بنفسه بين ظهراني المسلمين فلما رآه أبوه قال يا محمد هذا أول ما أقاضيك عليه أن ترده إليه. So سيدنا أبو جندل was like يعني they put him in under arrest and they tied him and everything, they handcuffed him, but he ran away and he wanted to join the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When he saw him, his father saw him, he told the Prophet ﷺ, this is the first person that I have to take back with me. But we didn't sign it. I'm not signing until I take my son with me. Not fair. I'm not signing. فقال له إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن لم نقض الكتاب بعد. We didn't finish. We didn't finalize. We didn't sign yet. I don't know. I have to take my son with me. فقال سهيل رده علي وإلا والله لا أصالحك على شيء أبدا. Give him back to me, otherwise I will never agree with you in anything. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأجزه لي. قال سهيل ما أنا بمجيزه لك. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم بلى فافعل. قال سهيل ما أنا بفاعل. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم tried يعني to get him in a soft way, but just give him to me. يعني only this, but it's my son. والله I'm not doing it. يعني back and forth at the end. يقول سيدنا أبو جندل يا معشر المسلمين أرد إلى المشركين بعدما أسلمت وعذبت. يعني he's trying to raise the يعني the anger of, show the anger of the Muslims, like how come you guys give me back to the مشركين after I accept Islam. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني told the writer again write and give him back. And then سيدنا سهيل بن عم took his son with him back to Mecca. And he didn't give him to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. At this point, سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب كما يعني يقول كتب السيرة غضب غضبا شديدا. سيدنا عمر was like so angry, and he went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. I think I'm gonna stop at this because يعني it's almost nine. إن شاء الله تعالى يعني we'll start from this point next week. إن شاء الله تعالى يعني إحنا we're going now in order with the points of the, we have two main things related to that great treaty. The stand of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu when he went back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and started talking about it, and to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and one of the great sahaba, his name Abu Basir. This is how to يعني, subhanallah يعني, it was hard and tight, very tight agreement on the Muslims. However, was a little gap there through which great Sahaba, they forced the people of Quraysh to tell the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, anybody comes to you, take him. Will happen later on, and it's interesting يعني, scenario that happened that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through which Allah made it easy for few of the Sahaba to join the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in Medina. Inshallah ta'ala will continue next week. Tomorrow inshallah ta'ala the halaqa is cancelled. As I said, we're going to skating. If you want to join us, inshallah ta'ala, in Rabbit Hill. I was thinking, man, skiing or skating?
Skating is like with skates on ice.
And this one, what is it? I don't know. I don't know the difference between them.
Skiing.
This is skiing? Skiing. I don't know the difference between skating and skiing. Inshallah, tomorrow we know that. Before I end, 1 minute, I need the five names that we mentioned. One. person, say the five names quickly, in order. This way, at least, I've been talking for an hour. Who's not number one? I need in order. Oh, Aywa? Ibn Salman. يا عم لا اقفل يا عم طالما فيها سلمان اقفل ودنا بداية ربنا يستر انا عاوز اروح اعمل عمره عند عمره في شهر ثلاثة نمبر 1 I need someone to say five of them did you write them down going now okay he's trying to write them down ما تغشش عبد الرحمن يا عسكر نو غش سليمان يا they're coming sit down, man. Sit down. Nobody leaving until we say the fight. Khuzai. Khuzai. MashaAllah. Khuzai. Should I say them? I'll say them quickly and somebody say them after me. Khuzai ibn Warqa al-Khuzai, Urwat ibn Mas'ud al-Thiqafi, Rajul min Kinana, Mikriz ibn Hafs, Suhail ibn Amr. Who's going to say them? Man, I just said them.
Khuzai ibn Warqa al-Khuzai.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. محمد ابن درويش المصري. طيب خلاص. لا start over. Start over يا عبد الله. Please. Start over.
Okay.
ابن وقار. ابن وقار. يا عم.
ورقاء.
عروة
بن مسعود التقوي.
رجل من كنانة مش ابن كنانة ها
مكدس
مكدس مكدس دي مكرد من مكدوس
مكدوس
no man I need somebody to say them please
all five
all five والله if you say them your dad will give you a very good thing not me your dad عشان ما يجيش يقول لي هذا يلا اولا مش بيبقى قفي دول ولا مستيك اسمع يلا ها قول يا عبد الرحمن عسكر you've been reading them in your phone for 15 minutes
وديل بن وقاء الخزاعي
المصري
عروة بن مسعود الثقفي
ما شاء الله
رجل من كنانة
ها
مكنز
مكنز غلط رونج مان والله سيد ذيم والله العظيم ها هنا سيد ذيم شكلك كده عاوز تقول يلا ها
طيب بديل بن ورقاء خزاعي
الخزاعي
عروة بن مسعود الثقفي
ماشي
رجل من كنانة
ها
مكرز بن حفص
بيرفكت اسهل واحد جزاك الله خير بارك الله فيك يعني اتليست وصلت المدينة جزاك الله خيرا انا وسيم ان شاء الله نيكست فرايدي السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته